Defense, trade, and maritime cooperation are among the matters discussed by Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo with his Australian counterpart Penny Wong. Let's get more details from our correspondent Vivian Gulia. Viv?
Hi, Denise. Amid heightened tensions in the West Philippine Sea, the Australian government will provide the Philippine Coast Guard with drone equipment, other technology, and training to help boost its maritime capabilities. Australian Foreign Minister Penny Wong made this announcement on Thursday after a meeting with Philippine Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo, noting that Australia and the Philippines are like-minded partners seeking a safe, stable, and prosperous Southeast Asian region. Wong said she also met with PCG officials on Wednesday. Australia also expressed openness to participate in joint patrols with the Philippines and to exercise freedom of navigation and overflight on the West Philippine Sea. Wong asserted that Australia is committed to continue its long-standing presence in the region and that it considers the Philippines an important security partner. In fact, planning is underway to further the joint military training between the two countries, according to the Australian Foreign Minister. On the prospects of trilateral cooperation with Australia, Japan, and the United States, Manalo said these are under consideration. Wong, for her part, said Australia is interested in working with the Philippines and other strategic partners. Australia recently augmented its budget for deeper engagement with Southeast Asia by $55 million to boost development assistance to the region, which includes specialized scholarships. Manalo and Wong discussed on Thursday bilateral cooperation on defense and security, trade and investment, agriculture, maritime partnership, as well as countering terrorism and transnational crime. According to Manalo, a bilateral visit to Australia is possible for President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. at a mutually agreed date. He added that the Philippine president also has an opportunity to visit the land down under in March next year for the 50th anniversary commemorating the ASEAN-Australia dialogue relations. Denise, back to you.
Thanks, Viv. Philippine Senator Robin Padilla seeking the death penalty for government and security officials involved in agriculture smuggling. We have back on the line Ara Perez. Ara?
Denise, Senator Robin Padilla is eyeing capital punishment for personnel from BOC, AFP, PNP, and other uniformed personnel of law enforcement agencies proven to have violated the Anti-Agricultural Smuggling Act of 2016. Padilla believes a mafia is behind those involved in reported smuggling. Senator Cynthia Villar said amending the law is timely, which she called failure and useless for the past 7 years because no one has been punished. For Villar, this is a reflection of BOC. That's why the public thinks they might be part of the anomalies. BOC assured it will cooperate in smuggling probes and make accountable even their own personnel proven to be involved, as the enumerated cases handled and billions of pesos worth of agricultural products that they have confiscated over the past years. Senators agree that aside from smuggling, hoarding, profiteering, and cartel should also be considered economic sabotage. They are also looking into assigning a special prosecutor to handle agricultural smuggling-related cases. Denise?
Thanks, Ara.
Rising COVID infections prompt the Philippine Heart Center to impose a no-visitor policy until further notice. The Heart Center says the policy aims to prevent the disease from spreading among its clients, healthcare workers, and support personnel. In the meantime, the Research Institute for Tropical Medicine is temporarily stopping RT-PCR testing for COVID-19 starting May 18. The Institute did not give a reason for the suspension, but said it will expedite the process of restoring COVID testing. The health facility also says it would stop receiving specimens for COVID-19 testing. Just this week, a couple of local government units implemented a mask mandate in selected locations.